Good afternoon, students. In our today online class, we are going to learn Unit 3, Light. Applications of curved mirrors. Students, curved mirrors are classified into concave mirror, convex mirror, and parabolic mirror. So now we are going to learn the uses of concave mirror and convex mirror. Concave mirrors are used while applying makeup or shaving, as they provide a magnified image. Magnified meaning huge or big size image. And then they are used in torches and then searchlight, and also in headlights, as they direct the light to a long distance. And then they can collect the light from the larger area and focus it into a small spot. Students, concave mirror can collect the light from a larger area and focus it into a small spot. Focus meaning converge at a same point, at a particular point. Hence they are used in solar cookers, and they are used as head mirrors by doctors to examine the eye, ear, nose and throat, as they provide a shadow free illumination of the organs. And then they also used in reflecting telescope to see the heavenly bodies such as star, moon, sun, other planets like that heavenly bodies. Students, here some pictures are given for the example for concave mirror. So concave mirror are used as a shaving mirror, and then it is used in a torch light, and then it is used by a doctors to examine the eye, ear, nose, and then they are used as reflecting telescope. Our next topic is uses of convex mirror. Convex mirror are used in vehicles as rear view mirrors because they give an upright image. Upright image meaning direct or straight image, not inverted image. Straight image, so that is known as upright image, and provide a wider field of view as they are curved outwards. And also they are found in the hallways of various buildings including hospitals, hotels, schools and stores. They are usually mounted on a wall or ceiling where hallways make sharp turns. Convex mirrors are also used on roads where they are sharp curves and turns to avoid accident. Types of reflection. Students, you have learned that not all bodies can reflect light rays. Only polished surface can reflect the light rays. So the amount of reflection of light depends on the nature of the reflecting surface. Nature of the reflecting surface. If it is polished surface, the reflection will be 100%. If it is rough surface, there only partial reflecting will happen. So based on nature of the surface, reflection can be classified into two types. They are regular reflection and irregular reflection. Regular reflection. Students, when a beam of light rays fall on a smooth surface, it get reflected. See in this picture, a person holding a mirror, sunlight rays are reflect on that mirror and then it give a complete reflection. So when a beam of light falls on smooth surface, it get reflected. After reflection, the reflected ray will be parallel to each other. Here, the angle of incidence, the angle of incidence and the angle of reflection of each rays will be equal. So this is the first ray, this is the second ray, and then this one is the third ray. So all are equal. Angle of incidence and the angle of reflection of each rays will be equal. Hence, the law of reflection is obeyed in the case and thus the clear image is formed. So in this picture, the incident rays, this is the incident ray. See, the angle is equal to reflected ray. So when the angle of incidence I and angle of reflected rays R are equal, it will give the clear image. Hence, this type of reflection is called regular reflection or specular reflection. Example, reflection of light by a plane mirror, and then reflected of light from the surface of still water. Students, this picture is example for regular reflection. So the reflection of light from the surface of still water. Our next topic is irregular reflection. So in the case of a body having rough surface, not polished surface, rough surface or irregular surface. So each region of the surface is inclined at a different angle. Students, when light rays falls on such a rough surface, the light rays are reflected at different angles. So you can see here in this picture, the light rays are reflected at a different angle. So here the angle of incidence I is not equal to angle of reflected rays R. So the angle of incident and angle of reflection of each other are not equal. Hence, the laws of reflection is not obeyed in the case and thus the image is not clear. So such a reflection is called irregular reflection or diffused reflection. Example, reflection of light from a wall. Students, up to this topic, irregular reflection, our unit 3 light lesson is over. So let me explain you book pack exercise, choose, fill up and match. Choose the best answer. So which of the following has curved reflecting surface? Answer is B, spherical mirrors. And then second question. The spherical mirror with a reflecting surface curved inward is called concave mirror. If it is curved outward, it is convex mirror. So here is the question, curved inward is called concave mirror. And then third one, the spherical mirror used as a rear view mirror in the vehicle. So answer is option B, convex mirror. So convex mirror is used as a rear view mirrors in the vehicle. And then question number 4. The imaginary line passing through the center of curvature and the pole of a spherical mirror is called principal axis, or otherwise the line joining the center of curvature and the pole is called principal axis. And then question number 5. The distance from the pole of a focus is called focal length. So the distance between or the distance from the pole to the focus is called focal length. And then if the image and the object distance is same, then the object is placed at C. And then question number 7. If the focal length of a spherical mirror is 10 cm, so what is the value of its radius of curvature? So we know that formula to find the radius of curvature r equal to 2 into f. So answer is 20 centimeter is the answer. And then fill in the blanks. The spherical mirror used in a beauty parlor as makeup mirror is dash. So answer is concave mirror. So answer is concave mirror. And then second question. The geometric center of the spherical mirror is called pole. The mirror used by the ophthalmologist to examine the eye is concave mirror. And then question number 5. If the angle of incidence is 45 degree, then the angle of reflection is 45 degree. And then question number 6. If an object is placed between two mirrors which are parallel to each other, the number of images formed is infinity. Third part is match the following. Convex mirror. Correct answer is rear view mirror. So convex mirror is used as a rear view mirror. And then parabolic mirror. So parabolic mirror, correct answer is radio telescope. So parabolic mirrors are used in radio telescope. And then Snell's law. Correct answer is mu equal to sin I by sin r. So this is the correct answer. And then dispersion of light. Correct answer is rainbow. So dispersion of light, correct answer is rainbow. And then refractive index. So refractive index mu equal to c by v is the correct answer. And then multiple reflection. So correct answer is kaleidoscope. So kindly mark in your textbook. Choose the correct answer. Fill in the blanks. And then match the following. You have to mark in your textbook by using pencil.